Hello, dear friends. We are on a new lesson from the study of the 10 Sefirot, 10 luminous emanations. It was written originally by Rabbi Isaac Luria, with great explanations by Rabbi Ashlag. And now today we are on verse number 6. So you see it's on the screen. You can also go to my website, lovekabbalah.com, so you can read it directly from there. And we'll read a little bit and explain. It says, to understand that word, you must first know the essence of a spiritual vessel, since the emanated being receives its vitality from the emanator. It necessarily implies that it has a desire and yearning to receive that abundance from him. Okay, so he says, כדי להסביר המילה הזאת צריך שתדע מקודם מהו מהותו של כלי רוחני. וכביותו הנאצל מקבל את שפח היותו מן המעציל, הנה בהכרח שיש לו רצון והשתוקקות לקבל את שפעו זה ממנו יתברך. So, we're talking about a reality called the endless. In the endless, as we already discussed, it's a reality that there is the desire to share of the Creator. It's important to, again, keep in mind that we're not talking about the essence of God. The essence of God, it's something that we have no ability to talk about. What we can talk about is the light that shines from the Creator. It's the thought of God to share. That's something we can talk about. We can understand, oh, God have a desire to share, have a thought to share, to bestow good. And the fact that there is the thought of God to share, to do good, it's awakening and revealing and creating an intelligent, which is the vessel, which is the desire to receive that joy. That is that reality called the endless. It's basically spiritual things. Means spiritual things, it's things in our mind. It's all in the world of consciousness. It's not something physical. It's not somewhere there in the sky or in the space. It's all in our consciousness, in our thoughts. So basically, we're talking about the desire to share of the Creator and the desire to receive. And now he says that the fact that the Creator constantly share its endless love, automatically it's creating within the vessel the desire and the yearning to receive that endless love. And he says here, no, that the amount of that desire and yearning is the entire substance that exists in the emanated being. Does everything that exists in emanated being that is not the substance no longer relates to its substance, but to the abundance that it receives from the emanator. So he says that's something like super powerful and important. That how much you receiving, how much you desiring, how much the vessel yearning and desiring to receive the light of God, that's the essence of the vessel. Means if you want to know who are you, who are we, what is me, myself, it's one thing, Rabbi Ashlag says. It's how much yearning you have for the good, for the light, for the blessings of God. That's define you, myself. Everything else that we have in life, the wisdom that we have and the blessings that we have, all those things, it's the actual light of God. It's the actual blessings of God. It's the actual good of God. But who are you? What defines you? It's only one thing. What's building the vessel itself, the desire to receive itself? It's only one thing, Rabbi Atlik says. It's how much you yearning, how much you are yearning for the light of God, how much you desiring, how much you craving for the light of God. That's defined the vessel itself. It's like very, very kind of unique and special and amazing understanding. ותדע אשר מידת הרצון וההשתוקקות הזו היא כללות כל החומר שבין היצל. באופן שכל מה שיש בניצל זולת זה החומר כבר אינו מיוחד לבחינת החומר שלו, אלא בחינת השפע שלו שמקבל בין מהניצל, ולא עוד אלא שהחומר הזה הוא מודד את גדולתו ושיעור קומתו של כל ניצל. He says, furthermore, this substance determine the godlut and the level, and by the way, many of the things that we're learning on the study of the Ten Sefirot, we not always understand everything. There's a lot of things that maybe we won't understand. But Rabbi Ashlag says, just the fact that a person makes the effort, as we're just learning, the desire to understand, the desire to learn, that's already what attracts, that's already what brings the light from the Creator into your vessel. Just the fact that you're desiring and you're making the effort and open the lesson and to learn the 10 lemonies emanation study. And even if you don't understand, the desire already draw the light. So he says, furthermore, this substance determines the gadlut and the level of each emanated being, each partsuf and each sephira. The expansion of the upper light from the emanator is certainly immeasurable, but it is the emanated being that limits the abundance, for it receives no more and no less than its measure of desire to receive. This is the criterion in spirituality, because there is no coercion there. It depends entirely on the desire. This is like beautiful understandings. Let's see what Rabbi Ashlag says here. He says that how much desire you have for the light of God, that's what determines your partsuf. Partsuf is basically the vessel. That's determine how great you are. Determine how much light will enter. How much light, how much blessings you have in your life. It's all how much you desiring the light of God. שהרי התפשטות האור, because Rabbi Ashlag says like something so important to understand, that from the light force point of view, the light of God is sharing and shining and influencing constantly without end and never ever stop sharing and wants to fulfill us. The only thing that actually would create a measurement on that abundance would actually might limit that abundance, it's only the vessel. The fact that the vessel wants to receive, but in a limited way, that's exactly how much light would enter. And if the vessel, there's an awakening in the vessel, and he wants to receive more light, that's how much light will exactly enter. No more and no less. Exactly how much the vessel desires. There's so many things we can learn from it for our life. It's unbelievable. אלא רק הנאצל הוא עושה שיעור על השפע מכוח עצמו. מפאת היותו מקבל לא פחות ולא יותר מכפי שיעור חשקו ורצונו לקבל. שזוהי אמת המידה הנוהגת ברוחניות משום שאין הכפייה נוהג שם. He says something super important. There is no coercion. The light of God is not forcing itself. It's not saying to the vessel, I want to come in, let me in. It's like, I'm here. You want to receive? It's up to you. It's how much you desire. I'm not forcing myself. I'm available all the time. I never stop to be available for you. But how much you'll be able to receive, it's how much you want. If we understand that, it's like such a deep understanding that we can take it deeply inside. God never forcing himself on us. Never. God is the endless love that always available. The moment that you desire him, he'll enter. And if you desire less the light of God, he would enter less. He'll desire him more, he'll enter more. It's all depend on how much you want. Such a beautiful understanding. No coercion at all from the Creator. No coercion in spirituality. It's just love. And love, it's not something that you force. It's just positive energy that wants and waiting to be revealed by you, by wanting that light. And it's totally up to you, up to us. Wow, so deep. And he says, everything is independent on the desire. And that's why we call it the desire to receive. That's the vessel of the emanated. And that's, again, we'll read a little bit more. For this reason, we call this will to receive the vessel of reception of the emanated being. It is regarded as its substance, and the reason that it stopped being regarded as an emanator and was denominated as an emanated being, the emanated being is defined by the substance that does not exist in the emanator whatsoever. For there is absolutely no will to receive in the emanator, because from whom would he receive? And he says, הוא נבחן לבחינת החומר שלו, שמחתו יצא על כלל להציל, יקרה בשם נאצל. מטעם היותו מוגדר במין חומר כזה שאינו מצאו במעציל אף משהו חס ושלום. He says it's very important to understand that within the desire to share of God, there is no desire to receive. Within the emanator, there is no desire to receive, only desire to share. Rabbi Ashley says, the Creator, he don't need to receive from everyone, from anyone. He's totally fulfilled. He's not like, I need to receive. I'm totally fulfilled. The Creator is totally fulfilled, and he only wants to share. להלן יבחן שיש בחומר זה a little bit more. Now we will explain how there are 4 degrees in this substance from katnut to gadlut. Katnut means smallness, gadlut means greatness of reception. The 4th degree being the gadlut of the reception is complete only in Ein Sof, before the worlds were created. It is the only one that was subject to the restriction, and we will clarify henceforth that it was emptied of every abundance that she had from Ein Sof and remained a vacant space. This is what the Ari means when he says that before the worlds were created, meaning in Ein Sof, this vacant space did not exist. So he says, just a little bit, 1 second. So he says, there are 4 levels of how you're building your desire to receive. There is the smallest desire to receive, that a person just tiny desire to receive. And there is the greater desire to receive, that I want everything. I want everything that God have to offer me. Four levels of desire to receive. And he says that the greater desire to receive, the ultimate desire to receive, it's only in that reality called the reality of the endless. Again, where is the reality of the endless? It's in our mind. It's in our consciousness. It's a spiritual reality that exists before the Tzimtzum. If you remember, we spoke about the idea called Tzimtzum. What is the Tzimtzum? The Tzimtzum is a certain kind of thing that exists, that occurred, that happened when the vessel, when the desire to receive said, I don't want to receive unless I'm also involved with sharing. I don't just want to be in the side of receiving. I want also to be in the side of sharing. So that's what the vessel said. And since then, created something called tzimtzum, or in English, restriction. What is the restriction? It means that we kind of created a veil. That veil not allow the light of God to shine and fulfill the vessel totally, unless the vessel, means the person, is involved also with sharing. That's the new kind of reality after the Tzimtzum. But before the Tzimtzum, before the restriction, in that reality called endless, right? It says that in that reality, the ultimate greatest desire to receive, the fourth level of desire to receive, was receiving the light of God without end. But it's only existed in that reality called the endless. In Rakaleani Sat Sodom Zum, only there the restriction happened. Means on that fourth desire to receive, the greatest desire to receive, there was a restriction. There was like a restriction that now there is like a kind of curtain that now don't allow the light to fulfill the vessel like it was in the endless. And it says here, that now there's space. Now what that level of desire to receive, the fourth level of desire to receive, which is the greatest desire to receive, now there's space. Why there's space? Because the light that used to fulfill that desire to receive is not fulfilling it anymore because of the restriction. So what the experience of the vessel right now? It's experience of space. Space, empty space. V'zohi kavanat Rav b'omro, and that's what the Ari, Rabbi Isaac Luria, means. That miterem shenivra olam, before the world was created, means before the tzimtzum, before the restriction, means the reality of the endless, there was no space. Means in the endless, the vessel was totally fulfilled by the light of God. There was no feeling of space or void. There was no experience of the vessel. Something is missing. Something is not fulfilled. There wasn't an experience like that. That's in the reality before the restriction, right? Okay, so we finished today number 6. I'm glad that you continuing to listen and to watch and to follow. Please continue, because it's so important for ourselves to be totally fulfilled with the light force of the Creator through these beautiful teachings, and not just for ourselves. When we're doing it, we're giving inspiration and we're empowering the entire world with the light of God. So thank you, and I'm wishing everyone great blessings, happiness, and miracles.